AI, ladies and gentlemen, what a year we've had, right? Since the release of ChatGPT last November, one would say we've experienced sustained madness. Come to think about it, though, it's not usually AI in general that everybody talks about these days. Rather, it's generative AI, the latest turn in a technology that's been serving us quite well for the last 75 years or so. Actually, in a way, artificial intelligence has been our unexpected and perhaps even undesired lifelong companion. Let me unpack this. Now, I assume many of you work at a company or organization. Maybe you're in the public sector or in education. Now, some of you know for sure that your company uses AI, perhaps for financial projections or for product recommendations. Some of you are unsure or even wondering, what does using AI even mean? And some of you, I guess, prefer not to even think about it. So let me propose a clarification. You're an AI user, of course, if you've interacted with ChatGPT or some other chatbots during the last year or so, clearly, but also if you've been using a search engine during the last 5 years. Furthermore, you're an AI user if you've used a content streaming service during the last 10 years, for example, for videos or music. And you might be surprised to learn that you're an AI user if you've purchased a book or an appliance online in the last 15 years, and even if you've been using an email client with a spam filter during the last 20 or more years. And this is because AI refers to a set of techniques which enable machines, computers, to learn from large amounts of data in order to mimic human behavior and capabilities. So machine learning systems, like the examples I mentioned before, are indeed AI systems. Now, AI research has been going on for quite a long time, over 70 years actually, giving us virtual assistants, of course, but also speech recognition, autonomous driving, and many other fantastic applications. So in a way, there's nothing really new about AI, just increasingly powerful tools. And yet somehow, in recent years, we've heard a lot more talk about AI than before. So something about today's AI is making it more disruptive. But what is it? Well, actually, in recent times, many people have been exposed for the first time in their lives directly to an AI system. This is a change compared to the AI under the hood approach of the last decades, which meant essentially releasing AI-powered applications, but not direct interfaces to AI. And this is the precise choice, actually, of some organizations like OpenAI, the company behind ChatGPT, or to put it in Greg Brockman's words, he's the president of the company, the let reality hit you in the face approach, and I think it's quite appropriate. And furthermore, what's interesting is that this particular kind of AI, generative AI, is very good at producing believable, plausible content like images or text, like this automatically generated TEDx talk, which is actually not the script I'm going to be presenting tonight, I want to reassure you. So, by now, you will be perhaps wondering, okay, but why should I care, right? And obviously, you can afford not to care, because AI is a lifelong companion of yours in any case. However, let me also argue that it's worth knowing what your current tools can and cannot do, meaning where they excel and where they're still limited. For example, today's AI is excellent at crunching large amounts of data and producing memorized content, factoids, which can give us very interesting pieces of information, and not that good at complying with human behavior capabilities, like common sense or reasoning or even human ethics. Now, what about your company or organization? I mean, should they care about AI or not? Well, now I'm going to give you three arguments why your company or organization should not care about AI and why I think they're wrong. So argument number one, here it is. It's along the lines of others can do it, we'll reap the benefits later. And what this argument refers to is the idea that we can somehow piggyback on other organizations' experiences without exposing ourselves too much, because let's face it, it's a risk after all. Now, why do I think this is wrong? Actually, early adoption means competitive advantage and in some cases survival for a business. Examples of companies that innovated thanks to technology and drew great benefits from this are Apple, Amazon, or Uber. In their respective fields, they've done great things thanks to technology, thanks to their intuitions about what the next telephone could do, for example. But then you may come up with argument number two, which is kind of related. It is, my organization is not an AR tech company like Uber, for example. So, I mean, we can afford not to innovate, right? And what this argument really refers to is the idea that not all organizations are meant to innovate with technology, which is, I guess, a pretty good argument in a way. But let me argue that the lines are getting increasingly blurred. Many companies in your line of business might very well be AI companies. Examples are companies like Amazon, which sold books online before embracing e-commerce and becoming a tech giant like it is today. Or neobanks like Revolut, which have no brick-and-mortar offices, yet they operate in a very traditional brick-and-mortar kind of domain like finance. Or even, perhaps more interestingly, companies in the pharma and biotech domain, which are discovering drugs and optimizing treatments thanks to AI saving lives today. Opportunities are endless in any possible line of business. But then, here's another argument that comes up in any line of business, which I think is the key king argument against AI. And this one's along the lines of, my colleagues or employees will be unhappy and frustrated because of AI. And this one refers to the idea or the concept that, to some extent, artificial intelligence will replace or at the very least redefine positions and skills to a level that will make us all eventually feel inadequate. Now, why do I think this is wrong? Is because there starts to be a considerable body of evidence of the contrary, actually. Studies like this one, which has been published recently, say that, called experimental evidence on the productivity effects of generative artificial intelligence, well, this study says that participants assigned to the use of generative AI tools, like ChatGPT, for example, not only perform their tasks more quickly and efficiently, but also enjoyed those tasks more. And what's more, studies like these also found that participants with weaker skills benefited most from these tools, which raises interesting perspectives about workplace equality. For example, for people who have lower language skills, but yet can be extremely productive in their line of business, which is kind of like a promising thought, right? Okay, so hopefully by now, some of you may be telling me, I'm sold, you know, how and where do I start taking advantage of AI in my daily work life? So I have some proposals. The first one is, of course, educate yourself on what current artificial intelligence applications can and cannot do. And this is because, as you may have guessed, this is a technology that evolves really quickly, and so opportunities arise fast as well. Secondly, identify a business question or a pain point where you think AI might help. Some examples from my direct experience include identifying ways to optimize the energy consumption of an industrial plant, or identifying occurrences in text that prove the impact of humanitarian action work. Quite an interesting application field, I would say. Also, predicting the onset of complications in a clinical domain, or designing a fragrance or a flavor artificially, or with the help of an artificial intelligence. There can be many opportunities in many different fields. Once you've identified an idea that you think you suspect can be implemented thanks to AI, get help. Hire a specialist or work with an external expert who can advise. And in here, many companies and academic institutions can help. And if you're not in a decision-making position, create a favorable culture in your environment. Finally, don't forget that AI should always be a support tool with you in the driver's seat. Thank you.